Hello, boys and girls. I'm checking in from Yantar a little bit before I intended to do a recording. I have been minding my own business here, and then I found some launcher grenades from a stash, and incidentally I was carrying the Tutiaba gun. Oh, I should drop these. Carry them. Maybe later. I intended to sell them to Saharov. Anyway, I discovered that there is at least this one corner here where I can grenade jump into the area, meaning I can access some of the underground, maybe a little bit. And I'm gonna try to do exactly that. I tried once and I got the top of the fence, and then I jumped into the anomaly that extends beyond the what's the word? Fence. Anyway, I'm going to just give it a few tries, probably blow myself up hilariously a few times. And this is where I have another ulterior motive. I have noticed that when I watch the gameplay videos that other people make, then there's hardly anything as satisfying and entertaining as watching people blow themselves up in their games. So this is my popular move here. Okay, jump. Shit. Oh, and I also picked up a third Mika from that stash over there. So let's see. Do you like this? I actually had some plans for the night, namely to drop two urchins into burners and make them porcupines. So I wanted to make a steel galavok, but well, I'll get around to doing that as well. Okay, that should do it. There you go. Now then, third Mika. It's funny, I thought I saved after I did that. Ooh, all green. Jolly good. Yeah, I also did some fruit bench repairs. My suit is in top condition right now. One thing to accidentally stumble upon a solution to something, and it's entirely other thing to attempt repeating it. Oh yeah. Okay, my health regenerates fast enough, I would say, and I'm gonna make a separate manual save here. These grenades I still have left are useful against the pseudo-giant down there. Now, I don't know about the... Psi-emission situation down there. Maybe I should switch one of these for something else, because they probably make me hungrier than I would normally, and I only have like one kind of food here. Can I go boom? Or maybe just take them off? Oh, no. Okay. Okay, let's just risk it. As far as I know, you can't actually like jump up that hole that you drop down from. Although, I'm not sure I have tried, I might not have. Oh, and also, last time I was all confused about the unique bodysuit situation. And after some forum digging and thinking, I put two and two together and realized that Saharov is speaking about Ghost's suit. And then I also realized why I couldn't remember anything about that quest. It's because I never turned it in the first place. No, there was a zombie there. Wasn't there? Okay, I might have to run back here. Okay, there it is. See the giant. If I could lure it through this corridor and into that fire. That's just a zombie. Oh, where's the giant? Aha! We're getting the Psi effect here. Okay, heart goes on, and I'm gonna probably gonna have to do this in and out and all that jazz over here as well. Okay, let's retreat over here. So at that point I think we reached the factory complex. So let's put this one on again. What else? Actually, I think I'm good. I wonder if this green shit here is like one big artifact that you could, I don't know, smash out chips from with a pickaxe or something. Effect isn't that bad. Yes, give me your grenade. Actually, give me all your shit and sorry, out. What I'm interested in is the pseudo-giant. Okay, and now we're off the Psi zone again. And back in. Okay, I can hear it now. To shoot the barrel, but I still had the grenade launcher on. Righto. Okay, so where was I? Leave this on bursts and on bullets, and I only have the blast grenades, but these are better than nothing. So this is where I want the giant to run to. This looked like the pickaxe I mentioned. Okay. think it will appear somewhere here. Hello. Follow me. Why can't I run? Fuck. Come over here. Whoa! Shit! Ha! Take that, fucker. Ooh, that was fun. I don't need that night vision now. I don't know if they actually drop anything. I've seen other mods where pseudo giants drop eyes like flesh, but over here I don't know. Like that hand-warming animation that the NPCs do gone horribly wrong. Okay, and I wanted their stuff. Still no ammo. Whoa! Where did you fuckers come from? Okay, I'm gonna have to retreat to the less emissive area. And now let's see what happened to those snorks. At least one of them is still alive. This is about the border where the emission gets too strong. Yep. Ugh. don't know how far I can actually work my way in because of the emissions. But as far as I can run back to the clear area and return, I'm gonna try. So fortunately the tunnels aren't just heading straight to the source, they are sort of... Yeah, here is a clear area as well, okay. Weren't there supposed to be some snorks over here too? Those were the ones that I encountered already. Snorks are quite vulnerable to headshots. Of course, when they start moving, it's quite hard to achieve that. This is the body that should provide the Fang's grave location, and this means again I'm gonna outright cheat and quick save before, and okay, let's try again. Until I get the data. Okay. Maybe it only works when you come out. I'm gonna try once more. If it doesn't work, then I'll just let him be and check back later. Speaking of attacks, about one day-night cycle ago, the Rostock area was attacked by Freedom, and I got some loot out of that. And speaking of loot, this is the point that I actually was getting to. This loner in wild territory who was carrying the fire dummy, I ended up buying it after all. Of course, after that I picked up all the junk weapons in the area and sold those back to him. because I hung around in wild territory and checked what would happen if he dies. Here's the hole. And when he died, he didn't have the thing on him, so I thought it would be safer just to buy it anyway. Okay, I don't know if I can. Probably can't. Can't get up this way. Damn it. This would have been such a nice endeavor to do Lab X16 backwards. Worth a shot. So, let's see, what do we have endurance wise? Also, once I actually do get around coming here, then I know that there won't be many mutants waiting for me down here. To my knowledge. Petrified goo. Base or a secret camp. Also, there's shelter from the blowouts. Relatively easy to defend. Also, relatively easy to lay with traps. And there's fuel at hand. At least until that gas pipe doesn't run empty. So it's warm, safe, perfect hideaway. Oh yeah, there's food. Did I hear zombies? Saharov that I'm hearing. Okay, and there's the anomaly on this side, so gotta be careful there. Whoa!
Great work, Antoine. The mission has been deactivated, and you're still alive. I need to warn you, however. We called in a couple of military helicopters to clear the area of zombies. You would be advised not to wander around unless you have to. Oh, and by the way, drop by our bunker every once in a while, won't you?
Right. I don't know if it's actually turned off. Oh, zombies. I want to see if the emission is actually off. I didn't think that just getting into the pipes would be enough. I thought that you would have to actually come out of the underground to trigger that. But who knows? So maybe these messages trigger regardless. Okay, how it goes on now. And it's still critical. Let's see how close can I get now. See? It is. I think the damage is still happening faster than the regeneration, like before. Can't go to the middle of the complex without some serious damage. However, maybe Saharov has some goodies for us for the brave work and everything. Still active, so the message triggered, but that doesn't say anything about the mission itself. Let's see what's hard to say. Oh yeah, also the helicopters aren't here.
Damn, not again.
I think those trigger when you actually come out of the hole. I mean, level changer. Nope. All the jellyfish are in the bar stash. Okay, so he will give me a scientific kit every time.
Hello?
Same old junk. I'm gonna leave it here. Oh, also, well, I'm gonna leave this one here as well. And this. So, what do I not have? I don't have the flesh on.
Here.
In any case, I have some urchins to fry. Okay, all the dolls are still here. Before I shut the poltergeist over here, I don't think its body is around anymore. Courtesy of dogs, probably. What's this? Pistol? Really want to pick it up, but anyway. Okay, this is where I make a manual save and start shoving.
Thank you.
speaking of recipes, I have been wondering whether you'd need to combine soul and droplets to make the soul drops. But again, I also don't know whether the whether it's possible to do the modification if I don't actually have the recipe in my PDA. If I knew how to make steel scale, then I would be all set. Yeah, keep that flashlight on. Of course, if they take care of the dogs, it's easier living for me. They are busy with dog. Let's see, maybe I can pull it off. Run. Bandits. works. No, it would be ideal if those snorks would want some bandit chow. Like Bandy and Duty, bandits and Duty are fighting themselves. I'm gonna check what the electronics say. Oh, the electronics failed me. Extra space between me and them. I'm gonna leave them to fight it out amongst themselves. And meanwhile, I wanna check out some bodies here. Let's see. They do carry artifacts. Oh! So these dogs actually do take damage from anomalies. Nope. Okay, quick save. What did I just do wrong? Okay. Let's check out those dead bodies here. Oh! This night has been quite generous, artifact-wise. Try again. Yep. Okay, where's the viewer? Can't be too far because I heard the pat of the little footsies. Is that the pellicle? I think it is. Shooting is a more immediate threat. Ah, mercs, by the sound of it. Now, here's a thought, Mr. Bure. Perhaps you would like to meet Mr. Merc over here, if that is Mr. Merc. Oh, that's Mr. Bandit. But mercs are also in the hearing range. Yeah, I'm just sitting here and oh no 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 no. You deal with the mutants. Too perfect if a blowout hit right now. Or like near right now. Yeah. Huh. Got that one too. Okay. I think the weapon accuracy is higher than in vanilla because. Where's the ladder? because I have been making some shots that that I don't remember being that easy. Okay, I think that wasn't a live mark. Shows himself. I'm gonna try picking up the. Apparently, I'm in the range now. That stash. I don't feel like getting up there all over again. Partially indeed. I don't get some food soon, it's gonna be sad. Sparkler, I don't wanna pick up a sparkler, it just adds weight to my inventory. I think I can start looking for food until I have dealt with the bureau. I can try. Just gonna rely on the display here and follow the bodies. Oh, exactly what I needed. One, is it, or is it the same? No, I think it's the same. But he sees me now. Uh-oh. Loot those marks and... and try to pick up some stashes while I'm at it. Third one is in the house, I think. Sell these to whoever is camping out on the other side. Come to think of it, this is not a temporary anomaly because it was here a few blowouts ago as well. Okay, I'll try once more. In this case, I'm not going to bother with the stashes right now, and I'm gonna try get past this bugger. Swap out the electronics again. I believe I didn't check out this body here. Oh, I did. And I did that one as well. Okay. Yes. So it turns out that I didn't modify any artifacts this night. But I did find plenty. So I guess that that kind of evens it out. Is that grass or artifact? Ah, that's artifact. Gravia, I believe. Like duty. The grid glitch is affecting the inventory. Okay. Okay, that's loner voice. Hello, let's do business. Mr. Parasite. That the microphone, I mean, and by microphone I mean the webcam that I use as a microphone, had slipped off. so I don't know how much of my my talk was audible here. Anyway, I think this is a good good moment to take a little pause, and after that I'm gonna check out these bodies here, maybe pick up some stashes, and then I want to hunt some mutants for body parts. So bye bye for now, and see you soon. Yeah, there goes the mic again.